I was involved with, like, occultic. They were cutting humans. If I had a problem or if I didn't understand what was happening, why are psychics so accurate? You must care about the source of a power. And you must understand that the enemy has powers too. Do not submit yourselves to powers that you cannot control. The Bible doesn't call us to empty ourselves and our souls. Aggressive Christianity thing, it will not take us anywhere. Hey guys, how are you guys doing today? My name is Amaka. For anybody who is new here, I'm just gonna go straight into the video. I know normally I'll bring out a video on Sundays, but lately I've just been led to do these spontaneous videos and I'm loving them, to be honest. I just want the Holy Spirit to move through me. Today I'm gonna be talking about psychics and I'm gonna be talking about, like, the anagram, horoscopes, all these things. And I must say that I was involved with, like, occultic stuff. I know, like, someone's like, what? Not in the way in which, like, I was a Christian. I am a Christian. And it was during my Christian life. Like, literally last year, I would, like, look at stuff too. And I wasn't looking at, like, horoscopes or whatever. But I was looking at something called the anagram. The anagram was created by someone who had occultic powers. And there's something called automatic writing. And automatic writing is a form of spirit contact where you allow a spirit to write through you. And pretty much the anagram has nine different numbers, right? And then you read the different numbers that it has and it will show you what number you have. So pretty much I did the test. A lot of Christians think the anagram is just a personality test. Pretty much what I would do with the anagram is, if I had a problem or if I didn't understand what was happening, I would go to people's Instagram pages and I'll go and I'll look at my number. So I know my number. I'm not gonna tell you my number, but I know my number. I will look at my number because I had done the test. I'll look at my number and I'll say, okay, like, this is probably what's happening. Like, okay, this is why I'm probably behaving this way. And this is probably why I'm behaving this way. And a lot of people would say the anagram is just a personality test, Amaka. Like, don't overdo this thing. Don't over whatever. The anagram is not just a personality test. It was made from people who had occultic powers. Now, someone's like, oh my gosh, like, that's not true. Go do your research. Literally, go do your research, Christians. Like, do not just go and dabble into stuff just because society and culture is doing it. And that was something that I did. And of course, also the horoscopes, like, right? Like, I'm talking about horoscopes. Horoscopes, Christians should not even be close to horoscopes. I realized this in our generation. We don't care about the source of a power as far as it has power. And you must care about the source of a power. I'm gonna give you guys an illustration of power and why power is so important. What if you went to a restaurant and you said, hey, I want a burger chicken, right? And you're tasting, you're craving it, everything. And then you eat this burger chicken, it tastes so yummy, everything. It's literally what you love. And then later on, you realize that that company that you bought or that place where you bought the burger chicken from, they were sued because they weren't selling burger chicken. They were selling human. They were cutting humans, exploiting them, cutting them their flesh, and then they were selling it to people. They sprayed chemicals on it and it tasted just like chicken that you love. What would you have done? Would you have been mad or would you have been like, oh, I don't care about it. It's all right. It tasted, that's the same way it is with power. The source of the power must matter. I don't care if they give me all the chicken in there for free. If that thing is fake and it is human flesh and they're spraying chemicals on it just so it could taste like chicken and I know about it, what would I do? Will I sit down and call all my friends and say, oh my gosh, I know this, but deep down I know that the power of that thing, deep down I know that it's not actually chicken, it is actually human flesh. Wouldn't I be wicked to call people to it and say, I don't care about where the power is coming from, it's not doing anything bad. I mean, people are enjoying it. I mean, it's tasting the same way that it would normally taste for chicken. Doesn't really matter. That's the same way people act when they literally say, oh, horoscope's not doing anything wrong. Horoscope's not doing anything wrong. A lot of planes are flying today. Thank you a lot. But I understand that we all want control. We want control of our future. We want to know where we're going. We want to know all these things. But the Bible does say that we should trust in the Lord with all our might and lean not on our own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge Him. And He, not anagram, not horoscopes, not the stars, not the creation, but the Creator, will make your path straight. The question is, do you trust this creator to make your path straight? The question is, do you acknowledge him in all your ways? Are you acknowledging him in some of your ways and then pushing some of your ways to other sources to help you out? Because it's the faster way out. In all your ways, acknowledge him. We need to be alert. Be sober-minded. Don't be drunk in the powers of culture that you cannot see between the lines. Because they will say, it's not doing any harm. You're not killing anyone. You're knowing about your future. Your future is important. But you could go to Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith, the Alpha Omega, the beginning and end. What is wrong with going to him? And I'm so sorry for leading people towards that. But I didn't even know that it was an occultic power that was behind it. But now that I know, you best know I'm going to shed light on it and shine light. Because when there's a vampire and they see sun, you know what they do? They can't even look at it. They're like, ah! And that's how darkness cannot stand light. And that's why I will shine light on things that I know are not of Christ. And this is not of Jesus, guys. Christians, the anagram is not of Christ. Because something has power doesn't mean that you shouldn't always look at the source of the power. The anagram is demonic. Horoscopes are demonic. And a lot of people are always of this notion of like, Amaka, it's not doing any harm to me. It's not doing any harm to anyone. If I'm believing in these things and if I'm reading these things, it's not doing any harm to anyone. Why shouldn't I do it? Just because something fits into the category of good does not mean that as a Christian you should do it. See, if it's not godly and it's good, then it is not godly and you shouldn't be in it. Period. Do you understand what I'm saying? In today's world, you must look at the roots of things before you dabble into it. And maybe today you're asking, why are horoscopes so accurate? Why are psychics so accurate? Why are anagrams so accurate? Because the enemy comes like an angel of light. He's like an angel of light. He acts like a roaring lion. It's not the same thing as the original thing. If someone says someone else who looks like Amaka, doesn't mean they are Amaka. And you must understand that the enemy has powers too. Do not submit yourselves to powers that you cannot control, right? Do not submit yourselves to powers that are beyond like things that are just going to destroy your life. Be patient. Wait on God. Build a relationship with God so you don't have to go into places that are like God. Go to the God, not like God. To be honest, if we look at why we're going to anagrams and why people would, you know, choose to go to like people who would read their palms and psyches and everything, if we are really real with ourselves, it's because we want control. It's because we want control over our lives. We want control over our destinies. We want that control. We want to know what's happening in every single area of our lives. The only person you could truly go to for real answers is God. Not in psychics, not in tests, not in anagrams, not in horoscopes, not in cards. You must be alert, guys. And I'm really going to be focusing on this topic of progressive church, because this progressive Christianity thing, it will not take us anywhere, yo. Literally, it will not take us anywhere except from seeking help from ourselves. And in yourself, you have no answer. In Jesus, you have all the answers. Maybe today you were like me, or maybe you are like me, right? I want to know more about myself. I want to be able to understand why I do certain things. I want to be self-aware, right? But don't be overly self-aware, whereby you start to go to the creation instead of the creator. Right? And if you want to know more about yourself, you want to know more about your personality, you want to know more about why you're acting certain ways, the only true person you could go to for this is the Holy Spirit. It is Jesus Christ. Come on, if a carpenter was to make a chair and I wanted to know, why is this chair acting this way? I'm not going to go to the person who sold me the chair if I have the phone number of the carpenter who made the chair. I'm not going to go to the person who sold me the chair if the person is not the carpenter, right? And today I want to let you know, Christians, you have the carpenter's phone number. The carpenter's phone number is God, is the word of God. Read the word of God. and the Spirit of the living God lives on the inside of you. Holy Spirit, why do I act this way? I'm telling you that the only person who could give you peace is God, not yourself, not looking within your inner self and emptying yourself. The Bible doesn't call us to empty ourselves and our souls. The Bible calls us to fill our souls up with the Word of God. Meditate on the Word of God day and night. You want to understand more about yourself? Go to the person who created you, not to the creation. Because the creation, we should all be going back to God and saying, God, how did you make me? Why did you make me? What is my purpose on earth? And so I just want to read something that someone on Instagram wrote. Her name is Allie, and she wrote, "The anagram, yoga, and horoscopes should have no place in a Christian's life. These are created by demons or for other religions. Children of God must have no part with darkness. If it glorifies another god or yourself as a god, don't do it. If you are in Christ, seek him alone." I also love that she said that if you're seeking to know yourself, where you come from, what you're called to do in life, how to be healed, how to find peace, the only answer to find all of these answers is the Word of God. Outside Christ, you always be lost in seeking answers. He is the answer you seek. God is the answer you seek. Seek him today. Build intimacy with Jesus. He died on the cross, not so you could go to another God, but so you could have intimacy with the Father. God is in control of your life. I understand that we always want to be in control of our lives. We want to know why certain things are happening really quickly. If there's a quicker way to know it, if it's just like going to Instagram and literally looking at my Enneagram number and realizing, oh my gosh, I like books. Oh my gosh, I like this kind of gift. Oh my gosh, I like this, that. And just going quickly. But you must understand that where the power is coming from is more important than the power itself. Where the power is coming from is more important than the power itself. I do not care if you could show me my whole future and that whole thing will happen. If the power is not from Jesus Christ, I do not care about that power. I do not want that power. And you shouldn't want that power too if you are a child of God. Today you have gone through horoscopes, you've gone through enneagrams, you've gone through psychics, you've gone through different things or cards or numbers or stars and tests and different things like that will show you, am I a this, am I a that, am I a this, am I a that. And maybe you are feeling maybe guilt or shame or condemnation. That is not the essence of this video. And today maybe you're feeling that in your heart and you're just feeling like, man, I've been through this. Maybe I've gone through this. I've looked at these things and I've gone through it and I've, you know, put my mind and my trust in it. I want to let you know that Christ already forgave you. And just come boldly before the throne of God and say, God, I'm sorry for that. You know, I'm not making these things up. Don't invite spirits into your life that will control your life for the rest of your life when Jesus is the only one who can give you true peace. So come boldly before the throne of grace because he's been waiting just for you and me. God bless you.
Open up your heart. Open up your heart.